I first started getting Achilles symptoms and started having trouble with it right before the Rio Olympics, so 2016. So it's been a solid 4 years now where it's just gone up and down and up and down and up and down. And I'm sure anybody who's had tendon injuries can probably relate to that. They're pretty tough to get rid of and they do hang around a long time.
Yeah, I mean, the nice thing is it's a pretty generic Achilles tendon. But like all Achilles tendinopathies, the devil's in the detail, if you're going to quote Jill Cook. And so there isn't an industry standard with them, especially when you're talking about such a specialist skill as pole vaulting. You can't just pull out the Achilles file and say, yeah, this is what we did last time and it seemed to work. You need to really analyse why didn't we quite get that extra little bit. And that's where the IMUs have been very, very useful.
It's just it's a tool to actually make sure that you're going through all the right loads that you see or you deem is the correct amount of loads for where the athlete's at. So it's been like, it's been really good in terms of just confirmation that you're on the right track, that you're not pushing too hard, and just seeing how everything aligns back to the athlete.
Being able to quantify whether that was a low, medium or high impact and being able to measure that build into more high impact, because you know pole vault, we didn't have any specific data on it, but you could be pretty intuitive to know that pole vault takeoff and run up is a high impact activity, so we needed to be able to build Eliza up into being able to deal with the volume and intensity required to vault. For me, the low, medium, high stuff was really useful, but then also the asymmetry. We talk about the Christmas tree one is something that we all latched onto really quickly, and that became, you know, within like a week of using it, it was clear that that's the one that we kept rolling, scrolling down to, and using that to sort of have a bit of a profile of what the session looks like.
Yeah, impact loads have been really interesting, the low, medium and high, and in terms of then you can get into the asymmetry within all those three sections as well, which is, you know, you're probably looking at a whole lot of the high speed stuff and where the asymmetries are there, because there's quite a substantial amount of load going through the limbs.
But one thing that we thought IMU could be really helpful with is just being able to measure that load, just as simple as that. Because tendons do not like changes in load, up or down, and so being able to track the load and make it progressive and incremental and not spike it up or down is really valuable, because as soon as I start spiking my load, the risk level of it flaring is just really high.
Yeah, the step data that comes out is really good. There's a lot to it. So I've been sort of relying on them a little bit to sort of just give me the graphs that what I've sort of deemed as the most useful.
I mean, I'm an old physio, an old dog, and I'm learning new tricks, and the IMU is definitely a new trick, but it certainly engages and empowers athletes to regain confidence through, you know, good quality work when they can see what they've done very, very quickly.